Look at the balls on this guy. Can't see shit. He's backing up the damn hill. And I know you guys can't see how steep that hill is, but... That's awesome. What? We were worried that if it would go up it regularly with two-wheel drive. Oh, this is a whole different ball game now. This is during the day, guys. Okay. 7 o'clock in the morning. We're going to get our biscuits and gravy. Oh, and this gardens is original. Yeah. It's been part of the plan that I read last night.
That's how you back up your car.
That was baller. I'm not gonna lie. I'm impressed. That morning at breakfast, we decided to divide and conquer. Chris and Charlie and Art would stay and use the GPR and try to find the bottle pit, and me and Matt would go and scout the landing for other home sites. This is what we found. All right. Out here on the Cape Fear River, we are scouting a site that the family also owns called Whitehall Landing. It's a really old landing. There's ruins down there. A lot of iron. It just kind of sounds like it's been hit before, maybe because it's been on the water. I'm not sure what the metal detecting activity is like here, but probably just as much as anywhere else. All right, first roll relic, flat button, big loop. All right, if there's anything else that comes out, I'll let you know, but how pretty is this hillside? Right down there's the river. It's a big slope too. You can't tell on this. Right in front over there is where I just took the button. We got a rivet. And it looks like, I don't think that's the road we came in on. There's a dip right there. Might be getting on something. We made it back to the plantation house. It's wild to be this high up in a deep water creek over here and there's like not any iron or any signals. I tracked Art over here. Jeez.
Do a backflip into the mud.
You'd stick forever. I bet there's shark teeth in that. Did you see all the shell on the other side of the bank when
look
we walked?
Right here. It's probably oyster, you know?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I mean, it's all up here.
Uh-huh.
It's a long way up. So it's an oyster shell.
Those dark colored spots. Mm-hmm. They look like puttery. Native puttery.
You should have seen all the damn turkey right here, man.
Oh yeah.
There's like 30 turkey right here up on the top of the hill. When I popped my head over, they all looked at me and like, "What the?" Scattered. They just went everywhere. All of them pretty much went across the river and they stayed up in the trees for some reason. Like they were filming.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, see it. That's funny. I figured out they really don't like it when you at them.
Yeah, not at all.
Had a bunch run for me on James Island. I was like, "Come on!" They were like, "Ah!" And it's pretty out here. I love the Cape Fear. So me and Art decided to walk around that big old cut right there. and we're walking, I start hearing iron, and Art goes, oh, brick foundation. Look at that. All underneath this, there's iron everywhere. Yeah, there's all kinds of stuff right there. You can see all the green brick, and I can hear all the iron. It sounds like cabins, and I haven't gotten a solid signal yet, but we'll see. We came to the higher bluff across from the brick. I got a relic. Probably a dog tag or something since they hunt. Let's see if I can get any detail off of it. That's cool. Well, I just walked a really big creek. Found a doorknob. Glass one. This place sure is pretty though. I was in that creek and they had a bunch of big brick, like all kinds of brick and stuff. I didn't see any arrowheads, nothing. I'm covering ground with a 15-inch coil. Chris is over there. Everybody else is trying to find privy with the GPR. God, this place is cool though. All right, so we are down here where Art was finding bottles. So, I'm under the house now. And I'm doing some metal detecting. We hadn't really found much. The oldest thing I found was a pipe bowl. And we went to the landing site and found a little bit of stuff, but just some buttons and stuff. But I'm down here giving it a shot, and there's some older brick. And I just pulled this out. I got hose. It's a good one. Looks like the ones I found in Charleston. Deep, small coal, playing around. Not sure what this one's gonna be. Just took a bunch of clad, a bunch of pull tabs. I hear about this really old tree. They're cooking up some oysters. Beautiful plantation house. And a 40. I'll see what that is. I'm guessing big iron, but it doesn't sound anything like it. It sounds more brassy, or dare I say so? It's definitely massive and brass. Let's see if we can get that. It looks like it's probably horse tack or something. A big lead. Probably those dogs you hear. That's pretty cool. I like that. Oh, breast stuff. Solid one piece. That's neat. Another gorgeous sunset. OAKLAND Plantation. What's going on, everybody? We're out here at the last spot of the trip. We'll probably go back by the plantation one more time, take some pictures, but Chris swinging, Matt with Equinox. We put Equinox in Charlie's hand, Equinox in Art's hand. I got CTX. Charlie just said he dug a buckle. see. And I just got this sort of tap. Got a name on it. Can't really see it. Probably says patent or something like that. That's pretty neat. Art hollers out for, oh, I just found a pocket watch. See, the reason we got these guys out here is we put together a dream team. These guys dig the crap out of bottles and privies, and with us in the metal detection, oh, dude. That's like, you never get them that hole.
Yeah, dude, it's almost all there.
Wow. There's probably more of it. What you do is after you dig this signal, start making circles around this in bigger radiuses, and you'll pick up the rest, because when they cut down the trees, it's pushing it away. So you don't know which way he was walking, but when you find that circle and you find out where he was, you can put a direct line of path to where he was going. Yeah. Wow. That's awesome. That's super neat. There might be a name on the back or something.
So it's just missing the cover.
Good job,
right?
Dude. Yeah. Sweet. And it'll probably be there, because if you never find them that whole, we find them in pieces. So it's going to be somewhere in this radius. Nice find, dude.
Appreciate it. Yeah, a couple pieces you're missing.
Yeah. See what happens when you put an Equinox in your hand? All right. Yeah, it should. Catching up with Matt. It's got design on it. Could say along with the president, you never know. And then that looks more like silver though than his. I just flung, where'd it go? This side of the hole. I don't know what it is. Top to an oil lamp maybe. Saw the reeded edge, I was like, I don't know. It's got a knob or little rivet thing, grooves right there so that you can twist it on something and clean it up. I thought it was gonna be a coin. Art is hollering out that they've already been. I went back and started metal detecting again, but they have found some bottles already, which is why we have formed the dream team. Because we will get every relic out of the ground that we possibly can. Let's go see what they're up to. What'd you get on? You found a pit?
Yeah, bottles. Nothing grand.
Huh?
Nothing grand.
Still cool though.
Yeah, Eye Water, some National Remedy Company, and it's just.
Oh man!
1915, 1920 stuff.
Dr. Thompson.
It was loaded though, it was like a little small little pit.
Yeah.
Chock full of broken glass pottery.
That is sweet. And that right there is why we formed a dream team. It's because we will get every relic out of the site. We're walking around swinging metal detectors and not even trying for this stuff now.
What's but funny is the person that's non-metal detector, the person that digs for bottles, found it with the metal detector.
See how easy it is? That's how I found that one I took you to on your birthday.
It's all because of that right there.
Right? Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that was about like a foot down.
Was
and
it?
It had a solid signal. I mean, I'm just like going over top of it. And there's no numbers on the actual metal detector. So I was like,
it's deep.
It's deep and it's not that much. Might be something decent.
All right. What'd you get on, Charlie? You get anything good? You get anything good?
Got a shoe buckle and one of the smallest damn flat buds I ever dug. It's like tiny.
Matt's playing with maps.
Shank on it.
Oh, nice. That's a nice buckle.
Yeah, early shoe buckle.
That's a saddle endorsement, probably. It's probably horse tack.
Okay.
We find those a lot. And
It's convexed in. That's cool. Got a nice big shank on it.
Yeah. It's got potential on it.
Yeah. I feel like there's, did you see those two oldest trees that are across the way? Yeah. I feel like that's maybe the entrance because I dug horse tack in that cut over there.
Oh, nice.
And a bunch of it in that cut that's on that side.
Yeah, yeah.
And if you're standing in that cut, those two trees are directly in front of you like an aisle. So I think I'm gonna venture that way for a little bit. All right, we'll come back when some more relics come out. We did a little bit of a scene change. We came out here to this field where we can look for arrowheads and find some relics. And there's a home site here somewhere. Wonder where it is. Oh, maybe it's the pot of trees that's not plowed through in the middle of the field. We're behind it. I just dug this. Big old folded up spoon. That's been plowed a couple times, don't you think? Dug another gear like I did at the other site, but look at all these turnips. I'm gonna start making it that way. See what's over there on that little rise. Pretty dang cool. Crazy that we gotten this opportunity to come out here and explore these thousands of acres in North Carolina with all my best friends. These people are pretty great. They have fed us, they have put us up, they wouldn't let us pay for the room. They've done all our dishes, they've taken us out to sites. I just really, really can't say enough about how fantastic the OAKLAND Plantation owners are. This has been a really great experience. I'm not sure how much more footage I'm going to do today because this has kind of been us taking a break from all of this, but definitely wanted to film this. But yeah, anything else cool comes out, maybe I'll catch up with everybody with some finds if it's more than what we've already seen. But I haven't really dug anything out here yet, so for that spoon, everybody else is coming, moving around though. But as you can tell, a lot of ground to cover. Of course, I had to venture off path a little bit. Check this out. I came down to the low area.